We're outside today and it is a beautiful day. So we're gonna do something quick and simple, something that will be great for a barbecue. I'm gonna char some skirt steak and then serve that with a pita bread, which I'm gonna stuff full of a beautiful avocado-driven salsa with some charred corn. You're gonna love it. First step for this little dish, and it's a quick one, from start to finish, maybe 10 to 15 minutes. We're gonna char up our corn. So you just need a naked flame. So I've got a little gas burner here. I'm just gonna pop my corn straight on top of the flame. And what that will do is it will char the outside of the corn, and I want that. You want black on the outside, and then we're gonna cut the kernels off and put them through our salsa. So while that crackles away, I'll move on with the rest of the salsa. Some capsicum, which I'm just gonna dice to go through our salsa. Chop that into little ribbons, and then turn it around and just dice it up. The good thing with charred corn is you can't really get it wrong. If you forget about it and burn it, you've just charred it a bit more. That's my capsicum done, so I'll pop that into a bowl. I'm gonna put all of our salsa ingredients into this bowl. So the next ingredient is our avocado. And this is what you want it to look like when it's ripe. It's sort of a purple tinge on the outside, still a little bit of green, not too black and not too green. It starts off green and ends black, so you want it in the middle. Now if you buy them green, put them in a room that's nice and warm because that will speed up the process. And then when you want to slow that process down, pop them in the fridge because they ripen via temperature. So just cut that in half. I reckon, from what I can smell, I reckon my corn's done. I'll take that off. Some nice char on there, some black bits, which are what I want. I'll pop them there. I can turn my heat off and let them cool before I handle them. So I'll just open up my avocado. I'm gonna dice it in the skin. So just running some ribbons, some little slices, and then go across, and that will give me a dice in the skin. And then I'll just scoop that out with a spoon. Now, as soon as I get my avocado in there, I'm gonna wanna put some acid on there, some lime juice or some lemon juice or some vinegar to stop the browning process that takes place. You can hear the train in the background. And we're cooking in my backyard. So this is my backyard here, and you're gonna hear a train get closer and closer and closer, and nice and loud. Some salt in there. And then I'm gonna do my corn. So I'm just gonna chop my corn cobs in half to make them easier to handle. And then a lot of people sit them up like that to chop them, to cut the kernels off. I reckon it's easier if you do it this way, because you don't make, the corn doesn't go all over the place, which it can tend to do if it falls from a height. So I'll pop my corn kernels in to my salsa. Give that a stir through. A couple more things to go in, a couple of shallots that I've diced. Some parsley, which I'll chop just a little bit of roughly to go in there. That'll do. And some Parmesan cheese. Grate some Parmesan cheese in. We've got some acid in there in our lime juice. We just need a little bit of oil. That's our cheese. A little bit of oil on top of that. Another little hit of salt. Mix all that in. And that is a beautiful little salsa, which is really versatile. You could have that with some grilled fish if you wanted to, and it's gonna go well with red meat. All right, pan on. It needs to be nice and hot because I really do wanna sort of char this steak. Put some oil on them. So this is the skirt or the flank of the cow, and it can be quite tough. You gotta cook it really, really quickly, only a couple of minutes on each side, and you wanna leave it to be sort of medium rare in the middle, and that's the way you get around it not being quite as tough. It's really good to cook over an open flame. If you've got a barbecue, you're cooking over coals, it's a great cut to cook over coals, but you can do it in the pan as well. It's just really, really hot pan. So the muscle fibre you can see runs this way. So we want to shorten that. So we want to cut it at a 90 degrees. So when we're cutting to get the steak ready to go in the pan, and when it comes out of the pan, we'll cut this way. And that'll keep the muscle fibre short, which will keep it tender. You can see the pan is smoking hot, which is what we want. So in with our steak. I'm going to push it down so that all of the steak makes contact with that pan, so we can get as much colour on either side as we can. So you can see, skirt steak is quite thin, so it's gonna cook quickly, so we've gotta get color on it quickly. I've got a non-stick pan, and these pans are great, but the reason we add oil is because it's a great conductor of heat between the pan and the meat. So all that energy is going into the meat and cooking quicker. We'll turn it over, and you can see we've got some good color, but we've also got these charred black bits, which is what I want. So it's a charred steak that we're after, and it gives it that smokiness. So it's the same effect you would get if you put it over flames or over coal, but we're trying to get it from the pan. I'm just gonna give that a little season and then take it out and let it rest on the board. Now it's gotta rest for a good 3 or 4 minutes, I reckon. So you can see how much the meat has shrunk. It's really tightened up. Sort of that medium rare that we're after. We'll take it out, sit it on the board, and just let that rest and it will relax and become nice and moist and juicy again. While that does that, we'll get our pita breads ready. So if you get, again, a naked flame or even a pan, if you throw it into a pan, you just wanna get some heat in there to bring the steam in, the moisture in, and it will soften them up a bit. So I'm just gonna hold this over the flame, just turning it, and you will see that it starts to come back to life, starts to become a little bit more pliable. All right, it's nice and hot now. So I'll cut it in half, and then open it up. So once you open it up like that, I'm gonna load it up with our salsa. Push that down. Then I'm gonna carve my meat. So that's had a little bit of time to rest. Grab a bit of that, poke that in there. And then on top of that, American mustard. It is a must for these sort of dishes, I think. And there we go. There's your little pocket pita bread, stuffed full of that beautiful salsa and some skirt steak. And I don't know about you guys, but I'm gonna dig in.